Thought at one stage, maybe about month before the end of it, Adrian, I thought, this is going to die a death because Crusaders just looked nailed on champions and there wasn't a lot to play for. And I can remember that happening several years ago, and actually BBC sent us to do a commentary on Championship One because there was very little of interest in the Premiership. But suddenly the battle at the bottom became so tight and so many permutations down there, and it was changing every week, that although, as I tipped Crusaders via Maclean's, that they would win the title, I did tip second Linfield, and I did say Glenavon would be in the top four. So, you know, if you're looking for a tipster at Maclean's, look no further.
That's okay. I'll give you a call. Just leave your card. I look at the way Warren Point are now relegated after what was, and I hate getting taken away from a referee, but it was an atrocious decision that gave Dungannon the chance to equalise and effectively put Warren Point down.
And you know, I would generally stick up for referees. I think they have a tough, tough job. I think the standard of refereeing this year has been awful. But by the same token, I had a long chat with Alan Snoddy, did a piece with him actually, and he's one of our former experienced referees, and asked him why the standard was so poor, and he thought, he just says, like a mini a football team, it's going through a transition period. A lot of the more experienced senior refs had retired, a new crop of young refs were coming through. It was a transition period, but there's a transition period and there's an awful standard, and I thought it was an awful standard. So I only saw the Warren Point decision on Monday night in BBC One, the highlights, because a lot of people had been contacting me through social media in relation to, you know, what did you think of that decision? And I says, I can't answer that because I can't comment on something I've never seen. I was away at the road races last week at the Cookstown, so I didn't see it. But when I saw the highlights on Monday night and watched that decision, I've seen some bad decisions this year. It was the worst decision I've seen in many years. How on earth any man in the middle could determine that that was a penalty the other way? If anything, it was a free kick out for Warren Point. A dreadful, dreadful decision. And sadly, that Warren Point team, who had fought so hard to get back into to stay in and retain in their Premiership status, sadly, they're gone.
Talk about things changing, and of course, we've had cup finals with difficult and poor enough decisions by officials. But I'm actually looking forward to this cup final. Linfield, Glenavon are two teams like to play a bit of football. It could be a great final.
It'll be a great final. It's a lovely new stadium at Windsor Park. You know, the stage is set. I think Gary Hamilton's done a fantastic job at Glenavon. You know, a team that were fighting relegation there just nearly for two or three seasons in a row, they were right down there in danger of being relegated. They brought him in. Questionable choice by many people. Even myself had a wee reservation. Hammy, are you the man to be a manager? Did he prove us wrong? Brought in big Paul Miller as his assistant. Another big loose cannon at times. But one day come in and what a combination they've been. They've just resurrected that club. And you know this, Adrian, they're not far off becoming challengers, I think, for the big title. The Irish League title. I think they're not a million miles away. They're not ready yet because I think they still have to strengthen a couple of places. But the progress is being made. The infrastructure's there. The fan base is there. The stadium's there. Everything's in place. They now have a really good joint managerial team. And I think they'll be hard to beat. Talking about the cup final, again, David Healy comes in. There's no bigger name in local football than David Healy.
He's a good season too.
And a different start, taking over. It's always difficult to take. It's like me taking your coat to go down the street today. It doesn't fit very well. And David Healy had to come in mid-season, take over a team he inherited from Warren Feeney, who'd done a good job as well. But not everybody's cup of tea is everybody else's cup of tea. Players don't really maybe fit in the best. So give him time. He'll need a bit of time. But having said that, put up a great fight for the title. Right up to the last 3 weeks, they were right in with a shout. The defining match was the day we commentated at Seaview when Crusaders beat them that day, 2-0, I think. But now you're in a final when not always the best team won the cup, said. The best team will always win the league, but not always the best team will win an Irish Cup. I know that for a fact because I won two of them, and I won one of them with the best team in the Irish League, and I won another one with an average team in the Irish League. So it's on the day. If luck's on your side and you have the big players, and some players do not perform unless the big stage is there. And I think Glenavon have more of those type of players. I think the Kevin Braniff If you take the semi-final, for instance, he scored four. What a game that was. And he rose to the occasion. Branoff's a big match player. Then you've got Bradley, Owen Bradley up front as well. Another lad, I think, who'll rise to the occasion. I think they've got the likes of big Chris Lindsay, big resolute, tough defender at the back. They've got a really talented young left winger in Joel Cooper. I think they just have more about them for a cup final than, dare I say, Linfield. Although you find that sometimes hard to comprehend when they have Andy Waterworth and they've young Paul Smith. What a find. He's been in the right wing this year. And they've got Jamie Mulgrew, centre midfield. Talented team as well, but you can't sit on the fence in cup finals. And I was brought up a Linfield fan. But I would have to say that I think this time it's Glenavon for me.